Okay, so course one, chapter six, we're looking at the marketing basics and satisfying consumer needs and wants by providing the demanded products. So what we're doing is understanding what consumers are asking for. We're trying to understand how to promote those products effectively to them through various marketing methods. And then we're going to talk about how we're going to get to those methods and how we're going to understand the marketing basics for items. So this applies to housing as well. We talked about an example. If there is a home for sale, it might cost $400,000, for example, but your marketing tactic might be it's $900 biweekly in the most desirable area with great schools and things like that. So that might be a method that you might use to attract and promote the products that are already in demand, but it's all about the different approach that gets you the traffic and the phone calls and the ability to connect with potential buyers and sellers. So in order to do that, we'll be talking about some research you'll have to conduct. Now, you'll study the consumer need and the current market condition. So naturally, if the current market condition is very, very favorable and it's a buyer's market, you're going to be focusing on advertising to buyers and marketing to buyers and also to sellers too. But depending upon who you are servicing the most or whatever you decided to put emphasis on, your marketing will dictate that. So when you analyze and check the feasibility to see if it's possible, if it makes sense, you take the supporting data, which is from looking at the previous sales, or you're looking at certain areas that are really hot. Then you're trying to build a strategy and a plan. And in that, we talk about the four P's. And then this question comes up on the exam, the four P's, where they take one word and they replace it with something that doesn't fit. So what actually the four P's entails has the product, the promotion, the price, and the place. So if we did a product was, say, a home in Oakville, the promotion was the $900 biweekly, the price was $450,000, it's a great price, and the place was a desirable place like Oakville, for example. So that would be your four P's. So watch out for the exam question where the four P's, they take one word and they switch it to something else. That's not correct. The marketing plan we talked about is an analogy. It's a comparison to something you would relate to, say, in the form of a blueprint. So a blueprint is something that has a lot of detail, and it's a step-by-step structure of what you're going to follow, and everything is laid out on one big plan. So the procedure to follow is there for you. It's going to allow you to understand what to do first, then what to do next, and then how to achieve the final outcome.
So when they ask that on me.
They might not ask that per se. They might ask you just for another understanding analogy of it, if you want to define it or whatever the case is. But in this one, it's a multiple choice, so most likely not such a question directly about that.
Okay.
But they would ask about the four P's right above it.
Yep.
The marketing strategy overall is the direction of your organization. So whatever your organization has decided to do and achieve, they're going to market accordingly. So if your organization is a team of realtors that specialize in investment condos, then your marketing ads and messages will convey that information over and over and over again to keep it consistent. Okay?
Yep.
Now we'll talk about qualitative research. Qualitative, think about quality. It's about the quality of research you're doing in terms of the in-depth study of human behavior. And that's we're trying to find out why that human behavior is happening. So we're studying it to find out, but it's going to be an in-depth study. It's going to take a long time and a lot of work. So that's talking about quality, and hence it's called qualitative research.
Okay.
Now, when you look at the opposite version of it, when you want to collect a whole bunch of data quickly in terms of maybe surveys or just questions and answers from participants, that's a quantitative research approach. So quantitative research is based on quantity. You've got data, stats, you're collecting questions, and you want to collect all of it from a bunch of participants and then put together the analyzation of it.
Okay.
And then we talked about...
Refer to it as mass collection?
Yeah, you could refer to it as a mass collection as well.
Okay.
Yeah, because you need data from many participants to make sense. Like collecting data from two participants won't do anything. You might want to collect it from 200.
Okay.
Right? So, and then we touched base last time also discussing reviewing institutional advertising. So that's when a organization or a self-employed business is taking a certain direction with their marketing. So let's think of it like institutional could be a plumber who just does his own thing. He's a one-man show. And then we could look at an organization which could be a lawn care company that does services for, you know, multiple properties on daily basis. So if we look at you and yourself and you say, you know what, I want to just paint homes on Saturdays and Sundays, that would also fall under institutional advertising as well. Okay. Now, specific advertising refers to your targeting within your classified advertising a particular property, particular address, or one particular item. So if you're advertising a home on 123, you know, Bayview Avenue, that is a specific advertisement in the classified that you're going to post it in. So it has to be for a particular item, or it could be that you are offering or a set of free movie tickets if you come to an open house at a certain location. So that's also specific advertising. So it's focused on either a product or a service in that case. Okay. And then we talk about direct marketing, which we see every day, very popular, very effective too, but it has to be done on a large scale. Direct marketing is when you're doing emails to people. You're not actually having any person-to-person contact, so no face-to-face, no, you're not really calling them or anything like that. You're just sending them off an email message, or you're sending them mail in through Canada Post, and once they get that mail, they can either decide to contact you or not. Okay? And then we talked about defining a postal code so we understand how our postal codes work. The first three characteristics of our postal code are a forward sortation area, which is like a big warehouse close by to the area where the mail is going to be delivered to. So in your local area, there's a Canada Post warehouse type of thing, which we refer to a sortation area where they sort out all the mail that goes into that vicinity. And then the last three digits of your postal code, they are your local delivery unit. So they are defined to the unit that is where your post box is located, say on your street or in your home or at the building. That's the local delivery unit. That's what specifies that that mail is going to go to that location or to that post box. Then we further talked about in marketing as it continues into push and pull technology. We talked about pull. So we talked about a website that's getting a lot of traffic. So we can think about a website like Kijiji. So Kijiji offers you free classified. That's very attractive because you can put up a free classified and get some attraction and get people to call you back. So if you were to put up some ads in terms of your real estate listings or services, so if you're offering a home that's only $500 biweekly as a mortgage payment, that might be a really attractive ad that's going to pull some traffic from an advert you put somewhere, or you could use Google AdWords, for example, as well. And they're going to all visit your website. So they're going to visit michaelbird.ca and they want to see what else you have to offer. So you're pulling that traffic towards your website by putting up ads and banners or Google AdWords or Facebook promotions or anything like that that can gain traffic on the website. Even LinkedIn, for example, can do that too.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, push technology is now you're in the hopes of getting some responses. So you send out an email from Mike Bird Realty. You're looking for people who are interested in power of sales. So you've got four or five power of sales in your brokers that you're interested in advertising. So you send that out as an email. And you're waiting, as you send out that push technology, you're waiting for people to come back in hopes of having interest to look at the property and get more information from you.
Okay.
Then we talk about AIDA. This is an acronym for attention, interest, desire, and action. So we took an example last time when we were talking. Say there's a coffee shop that offers a 2-for-1 latte. So you're walking by, you get the attention is that you see the sign that says 2-for-1 latte. You're interested, you feel like having one. You're with your friend, so you desire to both go in and get one and save 50% or get one for free. So you go in there and the action is you order the lattes and get 2-for-1 and you enjoy it. So that's AIDA. So something has grabbed your attention. You had the interest by proving that you were walking into the coffee shop. So the interest was already there. Not only that it was there, but you actually took action on it. So the desire started to follow through as you went for it, and then the action was you actually made the purchase.
Okay.
Then we talked about some drip marketing campaigns, which is very popular right now, because once you get really busy and you're showing a lot of homes and you're doing a lot of deals, your time is gonna be much more precious. So when you set up drip marketing, you could start set up pre-written messages through your email. Say you're using eye contact, or you're using agent coach or point to agent. There's a whole bunch of programs that have a back end option for you to create your drip marketing. That drip marketing will allow you to write all the emails out. That could be for holidays, or it could be for follow-ups when they visit certain websites you have set up. And they'll just follow up with customers to ask, is there anything else I can help you with? Did you know about our rebate program? Did you know about this program? Did you know about our home warranty program? Whatever it is you're promoting, you want to send messages back to clients and just follow up with them to see if they do understand.
Okay.
Any questions on Chapter 6 before I end the video?
Nope.
Okay. All right. So we're going to end the video now.